I think the result of the machines being good at chess and checkers and eventually a backgammon machine program developed at Carnegie Mellon Institute by a researcher named Hans Berliner beat the world champion at backgammon, for what that's worth. But I don't think any of these had any serious effect on the more general goal of making a machine that had something like human general intelligence, the resourcefulness, ability to solve all sorts of different kinds of problems. The trouble with these particular games is that you discover a few tricks that at which machines are better than people because the machine is faster at doing relatively simple things than the person. And so defeating a person in certain activities, it's almost like a steam shovel and a person with an ice pick. If there's no real difference except speed, then one isn't very impressed of a machine, speed or strength. And these chess machines were not particularly clever in any important sense. They couldn't solve other kinds of problems.